Just before we have a look at what is on the show tonight, he's been very quiet, sure. Very quiet about it. Paul Harrigan last night voted back onto the Newcastle Board of Directors.
Oh, back on.
Congratulations.
Thank you. Nice to be involved with the club again.
Why are you keen to get back on the board?
Well, I'm not back on. It's my first time.
I'm just
keen to be back involved with the club. You know, I've been out for 4 or 5 years, and because of, you know, time constraints and being busy, but things are a bit better now, so it's good.
Any policies, Chief? Want to share?
I've got a whole heap of things I'll be bringing in the next board meeting, but right now I haven't thought of them.
I'll tell you what, Chief. I hope you have better luck than I did, Chief. There's a couple still there. Love the Eagles. Good on you, boys.
Oh, hold it. There is one. It's Rex Reagan.
Long time since I met this bloke.
Know, yeah. Welcome back to Australia, Ronnie.
Glad to be back.
Welcome back. You used to date my sister, Reagan. Reagan, oh, remember
long,
that?
Long time ago.
A long time.
You're not too big to give me a hug.
Ronnie, come on. What did you think of the boys, mate? Their beer bellies. How did you rate them?
Oh, from 1 to 4. they're about a. A one?
Yeah, they're about a one. Excellent work. And so there you go. So plenty of tickets available for that show as well. 22nd of April. They're open all night there at Newcastle Ticket Tech. So give them a ring on that number. Newcastle Entertainment Centre. Now, Reg, champ.
That's my red-haired friend.
How are you?
You're looking fit.
Thank you very much.
No, no longer fat, should be fit.
No,
fat.
In the right places.
Looking
mate,
very
right.
good.
Thank you.
So we have to call him Fitty now, don't
now
we?
Now, look. There was a footy clinic a few days ago. 5 or 6 of the clubs got together and got a lot of kids down from the bush.
Yes, and, I did, Fat.
Yes,
you had did. Had a great day with Mario, and just take a look at this.
Ball goes to Reagan. And front of the stomach, and front of the stiff. He kicks.
When I was a punk player for the Singleton Sluggers, my old coach Snowy used to say, Rich, you got to play hard, you got to play tough, but you got to play fair. Yep, Snowy used to say, never raise a fist until you're old enough to get pissed. And that's exactly what I did.
Oh, don't get me wrong, old Richie boy's not going soft, unlike your majesty, fat ass John's.
He gets one little bump on the knee and he throws in the towel. That's what he's got to learn.
And today I'm at Telstra Stadium with hundreds of Reggie wannabes. So it's time to teach him the Reagan way.
Come on, you kids, let's hustle, 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 hustle. Come on, hustle. You, bring a bit of attitude to the park. Come on, let's see what you got, big guy.
Let's see what you got. That's very good.
Hey,
you're not thinking.
The key is you get low and you get focused, okay? And you pump your legs out, you pump. Okay, you watch this, Mick.
Pump.
You see that, Mick? Good.
Yes.
Oh, here we go. He's old Ruthie Reagan's favourite wingy. How you going, brother? Good to see you, brother.
But wingy, I've got to say, you know what I think you lack? You need a makeover.
A makeover?
You need a makeover. You don't need a queer guy to give you a makeover.
You have a guy just like me. Yeah. Are you interested?
Yeah, I am a bit of style just like you.
You've never looked better, wingy.
Seven. Barjas, let you down. I won't hear anything, but he's let you down, hasn't he, Higgs?
Heavily.
He's let you down. I remember getting let down once, Higgs. School dance, 1969, high school. I was dating this girl. You know, she said to me, Higgs, she said, Reg, you're ugly. I'm not ugly, am I, Higgs?
No way.
Am I good looking, Higgs?
You're a glamour.
Am I good looking, Higgs?
You step over it and you get your knee just touching it. So it knocks on, knocks open. You go one step, two step, three step, four. Oh. You can't get enough front up, okay? It's not about time, but it's about how hard you kick the bludger. And you get up and you stop and then you kick the bludger over. That's how you do it.
I'm going to give you permission to call the shots this week, OK?
Right, yeah.
Repeat after me. Go forward, you bludgers!
Go forward, you bludgers.
A little bit more feeling, Kurt. A little bit more feeling.
Repeat it again.
Yes, please.
Go forward, you bludgers.
Give me the ball, you bludgers!
Give me the ball, you bludgers.
Make a decent tackle, you bludgers! Kurt,
I'm waiting.
Now, Rusty, you enjoying your time at the Knights? I bet you're enjoying it a lot more now Captain Cranky's gone.
that was a bit of a disappointment, but,
Was he when you got here that he was here? I mean, I thought he was going to bloody Union. The rah-rahs. Stuart Pinkett and all those cats.
Come on, I'm the only one to do anything. Have a go, you bludger.
Was that one again?
Come on, I'm the only one doing anything, have a go!
Come on, I'm the only one doing anything, have a go!
You bludgers.
You bludgers.
Come on.
You're like bloody Johnny Young.
What a great day we've had. The kids have learned a lot. Kids, have you learned a lot? Yeah! Of course, Shavon. I'll tell you what, I think the players have learned a bit as well. Players? You better pull your fingers out, you're playing like a bunch of cats. I'm Reg Reagan, go and get stuff.
To rugby league and more drama for Andrew Johns. He's in hospital. The injured Newcastle captain is being treated for a blood clot in his lungs. Rob Canning joins us. And Rob, what's Joey's condition at the moment?
He's certainly seen better days, Ryan. Today he's been using on occasions an oxygen mask to help him breathe. He's also on medications which it's hoped will help dissolve this blood clot that he has in one of his lungs. Now, amazingly, it's the third time in about a week that Johns has been admitted to hospital, and this last time all the more serious than the others because it literally has been a life-threatening situation. I caught up with his manager, John Fordham, today. Here's what he had to say.
It's a serious problem, a blood clot, particularly in the lung, but it is a post-operative problem that can hit anyone. He got to it early, and the process now of medication should thin the blood out and get him back to normal pretty quickly.
Now, when Johns does get back to good health, he and his manager will talk to Newcastle about that contract extension that Joey is looking for. And I also spoke to John Fordham about the Australian Rugby Union. He says they are not talking those parties at the moment.
Let's hear from Newcastle coach now, Michael Hagan, also standing by with Jason Costigan.
Well, Michael, everyone's been talking about the absence of A. Johns. Let's talk about S. Witt. His moment has arrived.
Yeah, it has come around probably a bit earlier than we thought, but he's trained really well in pre-season and played very well in Premier League last week, and he'll get a shot at it for a couple of weeks.
And for tonight, you've got a few coming back?
Yeah, we have Robbie O, Tomo Sahu, Clint Newton, who came back from injury last week as well. So, you know, they'll certainly add a bit to our football team.
And your record here, not too bad?
No, for whatever reason, we enjoy coming here, and it's always a great game of football with the Warriors, and we do seem to play pretty well.
All the best.
Thank you.
They do, as Daniel Anderson told us. They have a very good record over there in Auckland. Here's their side, the same side, 1-13 that was picked earlier in the week, but there is that one change on the bench with Matt Parsons out of the side and Jamie Fitzgerald comes in for him, Junior. Let's take a look now at the toss. Our captains are standing by, Arwen Guttenbeel and Ben Kennedy, with the referee, Steve Lyons.
All right, yeah, the home side, toss, good call. 5 cents.
Ten, mate.
Heads or tails, your win.
Which way?
Your kick, all right, which way do you want to go?
We'll run, doesn't really matter, left to right, yes.
All right, I'm going to go from left to right. All right, best of luck.
Thanks, mate.
BK, you've been playing with injury over the last couple of weeks, nothing new for you, but suiting up tonight, a real boost for the Knights.
Yeah, I was always going to play, mate. It's just get through the week and not do much and, give myself every chance to play. So, I'm playing, so it's good.
And what about the Novocastrians? You don't mind playing here? Your record suggests that?
Oh yeah, you know, past records don't mean anything tonight. We've had a pretty good week, obviously a bad week last week with the results, so we'll be out here to fix things up.
All the best.
Thanks, mate.
Newcastle's outstanding run here in Auckland continues. Abraham gets another two, and it is high fives all round. 6-3. They led 18-8 at the break, and they've run away with it here. The Warriors still winless at Ericsson in season 2004, and who said Newcastle were on the slide? They've won this and won it well, getting the chocolates on this Easter Saturday. Relief for Newcastle, of course. Their second worst loss of all time. And Peter is downstairs with one of the Newcastle heroes.
Well, Ben, they often say that 7 days is a long time in the game of rugby league.
They do, mate, they do. And we had to dig deep through the week. It was a pretty tough week to start off with, but we clawed our way back. And, you know, we just want to show our supporters that we made a lot more than what was showed last weekend.
Well, you're also a lot more of a football team than Andrew Johns as well. It's not a one-man team.
Oh, yeah, look, we're going to miss him. He's the best player in the world, and we're going to miss him. You know, we don't hide from that, but we've still got some pretty fair players out there, and we've just got to adjust, and you know, we'll give a few teams a shake.
You talk about adjustment, you look at the halves, and you're getting used to them.
Yeah, very much so. Both of them, especially Curtie's growing each week, and he's going to be a great little player.
And I guess if we got to start the front row, you know, some of the work rate that came out of those two big boys, yeah. You got to recognise that.
Yeah, those two big boys, they should be very proud of their night tonight. They didn't play too well last week, but they came back very strong this week.
And you must love this ground.
I do, mate. Very good.
Take care.
Thanks, mate.
Cheers, bro.
Kurt Gidley, outstanding for Newcastle tonight.
There's one square!
Really stepping up to the plate in the absence of Andrew Johns. And he is with Stephen as we speak.
You're a man with a lot of pressure on your shoulders. You came to the party tonight. You must be happy with that performance.
Yeah, very happy. You know, all the guys dug really deep. It was very disappointing last week after a loss against St. George, but I think we bounced back pretty good this week.
That was a hell of a way to bounce back, though. That must have done you got the Roosters next week at home as well.
Yeah, that's going to be very tough. You know, they're coming off a couple of losses, but, you know, it's always hard to win over here, but they've managed to do it tonight, which was good.
Trying to spell some thoughts, how much pressure do you feel in the number seven shooter? Or you played a lot of it in the latter half of last year. Do you feel much pressure at all?
I suppose there was when I first came into it, you know, last year and a couple of games before that, but now it's sort of, you know, just in one ear out the other and just, you know, play my own game. I'm not Joey, but, you know, I'll just do my best.
You look like you had a hard night.
Yeah, it was a tough night, but, you know, I think we played pretty good and yeah, I'm very happy.
Master the understatement, you're 6-1. This is like a home away from home for you guys.
Yeah, I don't know. I remember coming over here last year for the first game. We got a win up, but, you know, they're going to be tough. Not sure if we play them over at home later on in the year, but they're always a big physical team, and it's always good to get a win up.
Well done, Kurt. Look forward to the Roosters.
Yeah, thanks very much.
Yes, and our thanks to Kurt Gidley. He was really, really white hot tonight for the Novocastrians. It's been a happy hunting ground here at Ericsson. And the final score here tonight, Newcastle winning a memorable game against the Warriors, still winless at home. The New Zealand Warriors, 34-20, the final score in game one of Super Saturday.
Ericsson Stadium has emptied quickly after this week 5, the first game of Super Saturday, and the Newcastle Knights have come home strong. They have now a 6-1 record here at Ericsson, and they defeat the Warriors 34-20. Tamana Tahu, just before that Anzac test, showing the form that he has probably been waiting to show for some time in this 2004 season. But it was the return of a local hero, and Pete caught up with him just moments ago.
Well, Georgie, the homecoming that you would have wanted.
Yeah, no, it's great to play in front of the family, innit, you know. It's got homecoming, yeah.
So obviously all the family and friends behind you.
Yeah, it's all the family and friends. Pretty big welcome.
How different from Otahoo to Newcastle, buddy?
Oh, it's been a pretty hectic 12 months. I went overseas last year just to try and better my opportunities and that. At the end of the season, Michael Hagan was good enough to give me an opportunity. And I'm just glad that I can make the most of it.
I know you're going to say you play game by game, but yeah, you look about higher honours in international football. You're Mark and Henry Farfeely tonight.
No, yeah, I am taking it game by game. I don't think Michael Hagan expected me to play this early in season. But we had a few injuries to the outside backs, and I'm just taking it game by game.
You'll be gutted if you don't put you back there next week.
Well, that's the way it goes. If I can put the pressure on the outside backs, you know, I'm more than happy to do my job, you know.
Well done today, George.
Thanks a lot, mate.
George Carmont, the former leopard, comes home, scores a try, and the Newcastle Knights win this one 34-20. In the latest edition of Big League, Laurie Daly said, do not write off the Newcastle Knights. They will be in the top eight, and Koston DJ, after that sort of performance, they will be there, maybe.
Oh, they certainly will be. They'll be there or somewhere about, especially with the form of Kirk Gidley. And if Ben Kennedy can stay anywhere near half fit, Costo, they'll be a shake.
Absolutely. Everyone basically thought that Newcastle were on the nose after the injury, of course, to Andrew Johns. We've got to put this into perspective, Chook. The fact of the matter is that, of course, they didn't score a try in Wollongong against the Dragons last week. Their defence was absolutely rubbish, and the Warriors were pumped up for this, no doubt about it. They hadn't won at home. So much for the fortress. That home record now only to be rivaled by the Cowboys.
Oh, certainly. The Newcastle Knights, they can also play football without Andrew Johns, no doubt about that. Their stats, well, they're as good as anyone's in the competition. Here we go, here the Warriors. Well, 20 points, Knights 34. Look at that, completion rates were high with both teams. 80% is good, knows that you're throwing the football around. 73 for the Warriors. 43, 57. Well, yes, for sure. The Newcastle Knights, they did have better possession and they were able to absorb the pressure better, Costo, and that's what made them win the game. Stephen?
Thanks, DJ. Thanks, Costa. Well, not a happy time here. The Ericsson walk started early, then when they scored that try to Martin, it all stopped. But, Pete, they just didn't finish again.
Well, they didn't. They had their opportunities, and this is what the game of footy is all about. Is, you know, you're going to enjoy your possession. Momentum goes your way. It's what you do when you have it. You talk about opportunity knocks, and it falls in your lap sometimes. You look at someone like Gidley. He made every post a winner. He played like a champion tonight.
Well, I know DJ had some concerns about the Newcastle general kicking game. When you look at Steve Witt and also Kirk Gidley, Steve Witt in short bursts, the kicking game's coming right.
Well, it was spot on, but it was a platform that was set by those guys up front. When you look at Perry and Walnut, and also what Newton did coming off the bench, yeah, as well, that was a good performance, backed up by, I thought, Ben Kennedy. Ben Kennedy, particularly in the first 40, outstanding.
Pete, that's a number of times you mentioned the bench. Are you suggesting maybe that maybe just the Warriors' bench isn't as strong as it has been?
The most important thing about this game is the contribution you get off your bench, and if you get the right contribution, then you're in with a chance.
That's us here from Ericsson Stadium for Week 5 and the start of Super Saturday, 34-20 to the Knights. Still to come, the Sharks and the Cowmen. Another great week and a great game.
We are, of course, searching for the best tries of the last 25 years. Vossi, I've got a new category, the worst ever decisions to award a try.
Okay.
Before the video
Fair
referee.
Enough. Fair enough.
Now, here's a nomination from Andrew Frith of Newcastle. The player at the centre of the drama from the game in 1990 is Tony Butterfield. It's a game against Balmain in Newcastle, and Butterfield pulls a short kick out of his bag of tricks. Gary Jack ends up with the ball, and Tony gets up claiming a try. Fairly excited, too. But have a look at the replay. It's an air swing, a shocker. Of course, Vossi, no video referee back then. It was just a great smother by Tony Butterfield.
That was disgraceful. Yeah. What about the way he got up excited?
Oh, we've got more than that. We've got plenty more than that.
Newcastle notched up a memorable 34-20 win against the Warriors.
The Knights returning home to Australia, and as the saying goes, a week is a long time in footy.
People were sort of writing us off after the Dragons, but it only takes a week to get back on track, and, you know, we've done that and just got to carry it on now.
Kurt Gidley receiving his own personal attention last night.
I copped a couple around the head, but I suppose it was worth it in the end with a good win.
One orchestrated by the Knights' new number 7. Kay Gidley scoring a pair of tries and kicking 2 goals. Evidence enough that after last year's game time at halfback, the 21-year-old can fill the void more than adequately with Andrew Johns sidelined for the year.
It's better playing with a bit of experience under my belt, you know, that I had last year when Joe was out. So the more games I'm playing, the more comfortable I'm feeling.
The win sealed in the death of the match, with New Zealand attacking for the win. Former centre Daniel Abraham finding enough juice in his tank to go all the way. The Warriors' record now a worrying 1 win, 4 losses.
Newcastle, they will win! Who said they were a one-man band?
That's why we're down the bottom of the competition. We're inconsistent in our effort and attitude.
And after the game, Knights coach Michael Hagan was asked if Kurt Gidley had moved to a new level with his play.
We thought that Kurt could lead the team, and I think he was really well supported by Danny Badiris and Steve Whitten. And we're by no means over the difficult part of our year, but certainly a really positive start for those young players. And I think we had a couple of young players that put their hand up, and in particular I think our front rowers, Josh Perry and Adam Ulno, against a very physical pair in CEC and Villasani. I think that was a pretty important part of our performance, and I just thought overall our captain Ben Kennedy showed enormous leadership all week and played with injury and was outstanding.
And they certainly need the likes of Ben Kennedy on the field throughout the season.
The Birdman comp was held a few days ago down in the Manly Wharf Hotel.
Yeah, that's right.
To raise money, of course, for those the children that were burnt in that fire up at...
in the kindergarten.
Yeah, in the kindergarten
up there in the northern
and
beach.
And Reg and Trent made a massive visit down there. Here's their report.
It's raining men! Hallelujah! It's raining men! Hey, Trent here, and I haven't been so excited since my last round of colonic irrigation. And I'll tell you why. I'm here at the Manly Wharf Hotel Birdman competition. And anything involving flying man, well, it's right up my alley. Let's fly away! Let's fly away!
Come fly with me! Let's fly! Let's fly!
Two hoots about flying, man, but the beer is cold. No, Reggie boy, well, he's hot to trot, so let's get stuck into it.
Some strange characters getting around here today, but the real reason we're here is to raise money for the Molly Wood and Sophie D'Alessio Trust. Of course, the other two young girls are involved in that preschool car crash on the northern beaches. And I'm joined by Molly's father, Scotty. And Scotty, what about this support from the community?
It's been incredible. I mean, the Birdman rally here today, this is premium Manly, and you know, 3,000 or 4,000 people, and the support has been unreal, and this is Manly, and this is Sydney, and it's just been great for us.
More importantly, how are the two little girls getting on?
We're heading in the right direction. Definitely Molly, we've been out of hospital for a couple of weeks, and Sophie's with a bit of work to do, but we're heading in the right direction, and that's the way we want to go.
Everyone from the Footy Show wishes all the best for the future.
I appreciate your support, mate.
No wonder Australia's in a shotten state. What do you think you're doing, mate?
I'm the original feather.
You're the original what?
Feather.
I know what you are. It starts with an F, but it's not feather.
Hey, guys. Hey. Hey, Luke. How you doing, buddy?
How are you, buddy? Thanks for
looking. Excited? Mate. What are you looking for in these jumps today?
Mate, just...
Length?
Manly men?
Yeah, I do actually.
Seen many manly men around?
A couple, yeah.
Anyone in particular?
No.
Come here. Well, when we're in Manly, the colour of hair is always red, isn't it, son?
Yeah.
Have you seen him lately, Paul Vorton?
No.
Alias the Fat Man?
No.
No, he wouldn't, would he? You hear that, fatty? What does he do?
He sits on lazy chairs and do nothing!
What are you doing, son?
He sits on his lazy chair watching TV!
Come here, give me a hug. Hey, buddy, hey, you played really well the other night.
Thanks,
mate. So what's a good-looking lady like you down in a sleazy, dirty place like this?
Looking for a real man like
looking
you.
Looking for a real man like me, you were about to say, weren't you?
I did say it.
You did say it, didn't you? You did
you
say it. Come here. Come here.
You want to
come on. You are beautiful.
Good.
now, are you from Italy?
No, Greek.
Greek? I bloody love Greek.
Yeah, Greek.
It's bloody tasty.
Yeah, Greek.
Ah, you're good sport.
Yeah, Greek.
Come here. So you're here for the Birdman, are you?
Yeah, Greek.
Oh, what are you doing?
I
know.
Reggie.
You love Reggie, don't you?
Yes, she loves Reggie. You're brilliant.
Thank you. What is that you. Again? We probably couldn't pick that up.
You're brilliant.
You're brilliant.
One more time.
We love you.
Love you.
Now, what was the first one? Say
with
a
brilliant. Brilliant.
You're brilliant.
Well, guys, Trent's ready for the big jump now. Now, let me tell you something. I haven't had something this big strapped on this Mardi Gras time, so it's time to party. Take the plunge, and as we stopped you before. Well, I've had an absolute ball down here. It's a real stiff competition. But let me tell you, any time that I finish a day feeling wet, you know it's a good one. Ciao.
After 5 weeks away, the Knights are back home to take on the Roosters.
Yes, a very special occasion up at Energy Stadium on the weekend, Tim. Of course, the revamped Energy Stadium, much more comfortable seating for the long-suffering Newcastle Knights fans. It's going to be very intimidating for the Roosters, who've been out of sorts of late with two rare losses in a row.
They don't normally put back-to-back losses together very often, but they're going to come here with a football team determined to get their season back on track, and I'm anticipating a much better performance from them than we've seen in the last couple of weeks.
Yeah, not many do, but the Roosters wouldn't be looking forward to the trip to Newcastle.
Well, actually, Tim, they've got a good record up there. They've won the last four matches against the Knights, but as far as Energy Stadium goes, they've won 5 from 7, but the Knights' record at home in 2003 was pretty good. They won 9 from 12 up there. First game back at Energy Stadium, it's going to be tough for the Roosters.
Oh, it's exciting playing up there, I think. When you play at the Newcastle, it's some of your packed house, there's screaming fans. We're all excited about it, so we don't mind playing up there. It's good ground.
Now, really looking forward to getting up to Paul Harrigan territory this afternoon for the Knights match against the Roosters, the new look ground there. What you're going to see this afternoon, there are 7,600 new seats at the stadium. And it's good to hear, too, that all the workers that have just worked around the clock to get things ready for today, they've been given free tickets, so well done to the Knights for that. But what you see today is far from the finished product. As we'll hear from the Knights CEO, Ken Conway, there's still a lot of work to be done.
We've got two more levels of grandstand to be constructed. The second level of grandstand is a corporate level. There'll be a club room in there that'll cater for 320 with full dining facilities. Three smaller club areas of 80 each with full dining facilities and 17 corporate boxes. And they'll all have individual seats out the front. So it'll be a dine-in, sit outside if you want to and watch the football, or stay behind glass and watch the football.
Yeah, so it's going to be really good once it's all finished, but pretty impressive for today too. I think they're talking about a capacity just under 23,000 for the test next Friday night as well.
In Newcastle, the Knights' injury problems continued with back rower Ben Kennedy leading the field with a hamstring injury early in the first half against the Roosters. The torn hamstring is expected to rule Kennedy out of contention for this Friday's test against New Zealand. After trailing 10-6 at halftime, Newcastle made a great start to the second half. However, the Roosters finished stronger than the Knights. Chris Walker running in one of the visitors' three second-half tries. The Roosters winning 32-22.
Now, Newcastle coach Michael Hagan was pushed for a comment on that incident and others, but wouldn't answer any questions and explained why.
We have no complaints. And don't ask me any further questions on the performance other than the players. I had a good friend of mine suggest that it's probably something I can improve on in my post-game comments. So this is my first opportunity to take his advice and focus on the game and the issues and the players that that participated in the game.
And of course, with Ricky Stewart having been fined $10,000 for giving the touchies and the ref a spray just a week ago, that might have been in the back of Michael's mind.
I think it was. I think that Hayes really
was happy with the way that his side competed. I mean, they were great. He was disappointed that they lost, and they did have a few decisions go against them. I think he might have regretted it today if the $10,000 fine was handed over to the Newcastle Knights. But, I mean, he's entitled to be a little bit dirty because I think they were on the rough end of a few decisions. But you hope over the, you know, the 26 weeks it evens itself out. And some games you have a bit of luck and other games you don't.
If you thought that was wild, just wait till you see what's next.
Let's get stuck into it.
Special guest host Andrew Johns. The Screaming Jets perform live. World-renowned hypnotist Peter Powers. And plenty more. The Footy Show.
Live from Newcastle. Yes.
Every Thursday night we're having a go. Are you ready for the Footy Show? Fatty, Stolo, Chief and Matt, they're the Footy Show boys. The Footy Show. Are you ready? Yeah! Are you ready? Yeah! Are you ready for the Footy Show tonight?
For the Footy Show, coming to you live from the Newcastle Entertainment Centre. Now, would you please give a big Novocastrian welcome to the boys, led by their captain, Paul the Fat Man Fortune.
Great rugby league towns, Newcastle. We're so proud to be here. Oh, no, it's good to see you. We've got a massive show planned tonight. We want to thank plenty of people. The Crown Plaza, we're staying at the Crown Plaza. What a good joint. Down at the Docklands.
Hello,
Paul. Oh, how are you, boys? What's doing?
Yeah, we're here. Yeah, hi.
Right, what's happening, boys? Great, you blokes must be ecstatic.
Just, so good to be back.
What about Paul Harrigan? What a good bloke.
I've got to say, couldn't be any prouder. Couldn't be any prouder today. Wonderful crowd here tonight, and great football buzz about the town.
Tomorrow,
big one tomorrow.
Great night, great match. Oh.
Great crowd here tonight. We've actually got a sellout down on the Central Coast as well for our city country fixture.
Well, one of Newcastle's favourite. You like Reg Reagan? Well, we love Reg Reagan, and we went to, Matty Johnson and I actually went to the Logies last Sunday night. Once again, we got beaten by the stinking AFL show. It stinks. Well done, boys. We're in second again. Too good for us.
Stinks.
But Reggie was there, and here's a little Logies teaser. You'll see the rest of it a bit later.
Standing here with a couple of good old friends of mine, Delts Goodrum and the Pooh.
Gives a hug.
The Broncos, lucky. That umpire.
Molly.
That umpire. Yeah. What about that umpire?
What about him?
Broncos.
Molly, what sucks. About...
Hello, come buddy. Here. Come here, Daryl.
Oh, aren't you just an old bloody wisecracking smarter?
Reggie would have sniffed some quality hair at the ladies.
Actually,
quality.
Reggie's back in town. He decided to, he's up here visiting a few old shaggers at the retirement village in Cessnock, actually. So.
They tell me there's a long list as well.
Oh, it's long.
And it's long, Reggie's been on the streets of Newcastle. Of course, Newcastle this week is the hub of rugby league around the world.
Centre of the universe.
And Reggie's out on the streets. Here he is.
Who's going to win the test tomorrow night, darling?
Australia.
And how good is it? Fat ass Johns is not going to be on that field.
Oh, no, we need him there. Arsenal.
Oh, you do not need him there. You got the Gower. The power of Gower in the shower.
It's great. The test match for the Wolves at Newcastle, isn't it?
Yeah. Spell that here, darling. Spell that, guys.
Oh, the sweet smell of the Novocastrian city. Yes. Do that again for me. One more time. Oh, brought back a lot of memories, that.
I bet it did.
Look at Stacey. The two little monkeys aren't there. Jones and Johns. They're both missing.
You're calling Johns a monkey? I don't think he'd be real happy about that.
Oh, well, are we going to be happy about that? What's he going to do? Oh, come and take a shot, fat ass. Going to smash him. Can you say that?
Smash him.
Or as they would say, we're going to smash him. We're going to smash him. Can you say that?
We're going to smash them.
That's it. Who's going to win the test tomorrow night?
Australia.
Australia. Can you say it with a little bit more passion?
Australia.
A little bit more passion.
Australia.
One more time.
Australia.
One more time.
Australia.
Hey, old noogie monster, how you going? Oh, I hope you will. Oh. Do you?
Yes.
What about that? I mean, have you seen Mr. Ivory Tower floating around here, fat ass Johns? Does he get down this way? No, probably not. Doesn't come around the common people, does he?
No.
And sits up there in his bloody castle in the sky. Oh, look at all of them down there.
I got a blood clot.
Furball. It's a furball. You're a cat. These days, Kiwis are a pain in the neck, aren't they?
Oh, yeah.
Bring back, what does it say?
Bring back the beef. We did that again after that.
Down, bang it on.
Yeah, tomorrow night's test is going to be an absolute belter. Who's going to win, guys?
Aussie!
Oh, you better believe it. Listen, do yourself a favour. Grab a slab of beer, put your ass on the couch, switch into Channel 9 from 8:30 and enjoy all the action. I'm Reg Reagan. Go and get stuff!
Well done, Reggie. Now look, honestly, our next guest is going to blow you away, Newcastle. He's the greatest player ever to play the game, Andrew Johns. What's doing, champ? How's that pin?
Very little, mate. I can tell you very little.
I'll tell you what, first of all, you walked on. How much you weigh? You've lost a lot of weight. You've lost your backside too, I've got to
say. Oh, that's it.
Mate, it's very...
I'll tell you what, that'd be 6 stone, Chief.
Yeah, how much you weighing now?
I've lost about 8 kilos, so anyone out there looking to lose weight, I recommend getting a blood clot. It's really good for
you. Now, you've had massive drama. First of all, you did, you know, you had the operation. Great doctor, Michael Johnson, Neil helping me, looking after you, but
yeah.
You had blood clots, then it went to your chest and you nearly died. Honestly.
Yeah, I had the knee reconstruction, went well, then I got an infection, went back in, and then because I was on my backside so much... You want to have a giggle? I got a clot and it travelled in my lungs, yeah. So I was in good hands. I'd like to thank everyone at the John Hunter Hospital and Baulkham Hills for looking after me.
Joey, when can you start doing something? When do you touch yourself on the forehead and throw away the crutches? Like when?
I think I'll go back for a scan in about 4 weeks, just to see if the graft's taken hold. Hopefully throw away the crutches then, and then start light training and then... Pretty much it's about a 6 month to 9 month recovery, so I'll be right for hopefully next year.
What about last week, boys? Just thanks, Joey, for that, okay?
Yeah.
And, mate, more importantly, have you got the will filled out? The will's okay?
Yes.
But, boys, what about last week, honestly? Just move along to the big fella. Mate, you must have been from another planet last week, that Vomitron. I mean, do you want to have another look at the Vomitron?
The Vomitron.
I mean, just take a look at that. I mean, this doesn't get much better than this, Pat.
Well, I tell you what. What about here we go.
Johnsy, get out of there.
Stop!
Get out.
Stop it!
Mate, you listen. Listen to us when I say stop. Stop it.
Oh!
shot.
I want to kill you, Johns. Wait, I don't want to do this. Wait, I'm f***ing already. I'm going twice, mate. I'm knocking it off.
Daredevil dudes. Stickers.
There it was. It just makes me sick looking at it again.
It's not good.
Honestly, Chief, the worst day of my life.
That was absolute madness. That ride should be illegal. And I said it last week, but what about the size of my mouth? You guys have been calling me Warren because you reckon you fit rabbits down my mouth. It's that big. Unbelievable.
Oh, there you go. That was by popular demand. It was so well received last week. Everyone wanted to see it again, so you've done that. But now it's time to talk about a footy. Of course, Australia take on New Zealand tomorrow night in the only test match for this year here in Australia. And two of the stars from Australia join us. Please make them welcome the captain, Darren Lockyer, and of course, Danny Medeiros.
Pretty good looking kids, aren't they?
Welcome, boys. Girls, you like them?
Love Danny.
They're not bad. Welcome, boys. And of course, a big week for you up here in Newcastle. This is a great rugby league town. It must have been a pretty exciting week for you, Darren.
Yeah, it's been great. Everyone in the town's been very appreciative of us being here, and I suppose. Coming to Newcastle, for me, it's usually getting booed in the street. This time, we're getting cheers.
So you're going to enjoy running out of the Newcastle home dressing sheds, because the away ones are pretty rough. Just cement floors. We always hose them out on you guys too, but that'll be something good. You're looking forward to that?
Yeah, no, we'll hopefully get some hot showers after the game as well.
Sure, absolutely.
Danny, a test match in front of your home crowd, like, that must be something very, very special. It's different to playing in Sydney or Brisbane, but to be here in Newcastle.
You don't get many chances of playing a test match anywhere in the world, let alone you're going to be playing one in your backyard. So it's a great privilege, and it's always a great honour to pull on the green and gold, yeah.
What about this week? It's only a very short preparation. What kind of things have you sort of concentrated on? I guess keeping it just simple. Yeah.
Well, since we got in on Sunday night, it's really been an organised camp, and we've kept it simple. You don't need to overcoach in a rep team, and we've really just... got a bit of combination together and stuff like that, and defence is going to be the key for us tomorrow night.
Yeah, Lockie, where do you think the strengths are on the Kiwi side?
Oh, they're big all over the park, and obviously they've picked a 5'8 that has got a fair bit of size, so they're obviously focused on their defence, and I think it's a matter of us just getting the quick play of the balls and trying to turn the big guys around.
There's the team there on the screen right now. They are a side that has trouble during the week. They've had Ribbon Wiki pull out. They've had a few other problems. But as we've seen in the past, the New Zealand team always performs.
Well, I remember years ago pulling Nelson Filipano out of reserve grade for North Sydney and played all over Wally.
Yeah.
Well, sorry about that, Wally. And there's the Australian side. They, I mean, look, they, I often say you can pick three Australian sides and be a great side, but very special.
I think a lot of people actually forget. I know different circumstances and even different squads, but their last start winners. They actually won the last test back in October. So that's got to be in the back of the mind.
Yeah, we're definitely not going to go in the game complacent. You know, they got us last time over there in New Zealand, and there's been talk of their players in poor form, but when they pull on their jersey for New Zealand, they definitely grow an arm and a leg.
Well, Danny, what about Robbie Paul? I think you played against him in the World Club Challenge. Had quite a bit to say during the week about Energy Australia Stadium. Doesn't like the ground too much, which is unfortunate, but you're looking forward to having a go against him? Mate, he's given us a hard time about the ground.
It's unfortunate.
He sprayed the ground. He said it's not exciting, not daunting. We'll have to find out tomorrow night.
I don't know if Robbie's ever played there, so we'll see tomorrow night. You know, we'll pack it out, I'd say. And you know, it'll be a great atmosphere. So we've got a new stadium on the way, so it'll be great.
Matt Ridley back to his brother Kurt. Kurt, a one-hand effort. Will no! He's in to score! Back to Andrew, he puts it up high. The jump is on, they're outnumbered, but it doesn't matter. Cooper, oh, he passed the ball. Waldo slams it down.
At the moment, I'm into Jack Johnson, Love My Jet, and a bloke called G-Love and a special sauce. Probably every time we run out to Energy Australia Stadium, it's a pretty special moment running out there and capacity crowd, yeah. Probably the yearly drubbings or the floggings we get every year. A couple of years ago, Cronulla, this year, St George. Probably my father. He's always guided me through my football and you know, he's always ringing me on game day and wishing me luck. So I have to say my dad.
Got one under runner, and here's Walno will score under the post for the Newcastle Knights.
Probably off the movie Shawshank Redemption, Get Busy Living or Get Busy Dying. I like to think of myself as an Aussie bloke. Do always find out the family background and don't let your date pay. Just someone to make them feel like a princess. At the moment, because of music taste, probably Jack Johnson. Love to have a beer with him. Seems like a cruisy bloke and maybe a few yarns, I'd say. So Jack Johnson.
Big night in Newcastle tonight. Last Sunday night, it was a big night in Melbourne. Reg was our man at the Logies.
Let me just say this, Daryl, I loved you. Where's Ozzy? Where's Daryl? Where's Ozzy?
Mate, don't worry about that.
Where is he?
It's Dickie, now you're going to watch me.
Come here, Daryl.
Oh, thanks, mate.
Where are you going, Sebastian? Hey, listen, what everyone wants to know, how long till the first Ron Coot? You've got to do it. Give us a hug. You're a good kid. You're a good kid.
Hey, bad about the Bunnies last night.
That's the worst piece of crap I ever saw in my life. What planet are you from?
Uranus.
Standing here with a couple of good old friends of mine. Delts Goodrum and the Pooh, Philippus, is he treating you all right? Is he treating you all right? Because I tell you, if you're not treating him all right, you're going to deal with me, buddy.
Okay. I am. I'm trying to be, you know, the good boyfriend, supportive. That's why I'm here. I'm supporting her. I'm doing the right thing.
Guys, do you know I didn't even get a start tonight at the awards?
You didn't get a what?
A start?
They didn't even give me an invitation. You know why? They said I wasn't good looking enough.
Oh, that-
No, you're very good looking.
Delta, am I good looking?
You're extremely good looking.
Am I good looking?
Am
I good looking?
You are good looking. I don't know what happened, but that happens sometimes.
You could good looking. You know, yes, you're very good looking.
Am I good looking?
It's all right. It's all right.
Can I have a hug?
Of course you can.
Come and give us a hug. Oh, we're beautiful. Both of us.
Now listen here. You big bloody Greek Adonis.
I've heard about you, Greek Adonis. I've heard about you, Greek. You know, in the modern Olympics, they used to run around the nude, the Greeks.
I know.
How good's that?
That is good. That is really good.
You have a chance of playing Wimbledon the nude?
If I want a bit of an edge, put him up a little, like, I don't know. That could be a little scary, though.
I've seen the package. It might be just more than a little bit of an edge, let me tell you.
Reds, it's an absolute pleasure to watch you. I'm from Melbourne. Yeah. You come on very late at night. You make me feel happy deep down inside when I'm in bed.
How deep?
Very deep.
I tell you what, mate, you ain't no talent ever went and bit you on the ass.
Hello, Paulina. You're looking great, darling.
Aren't you just an old bloody wise cracking smart ass?
Close your eyes and I'll kiss you. Tomorrow I'll miss you. Remember, I'll always be true. And while I'm away, I'll ride home every day.
I reckon you're right.
And
too.
I'll stand all my loving to you.
He's a poof. Good night, Australia. What a 7 standards. 7 inches.
That's what they reckon. Come on.
You want me to speak personally? I'm sorry, modesty prevents me. See ya.
Sharon Gadello, a bloody huge Remington, eh? They call you huge enough. That's the old that's the word on the street, old.
You are just beautiful.
So can you say that again?
You are just so beautiful.
I like your books.
I like the mustache.
Do you?
I do. Could I remind you? Sexy.
Do you remind you of anyone?
Almost my dad, but not quite.
Come here. Did your dad used to give you cuddles? Did your dad used to give you cuddles?
He used to give me a kiss right here, though.
Come here, you old shagger.
Tickles! Tickles!
How good are the Melbourne Storm, old son?
54, Rabbitohs. Should have been Penrith the before.
No! Should have been...
The Broncos. Lucky. That umpire.
Molly.
That umpire. Yeah. What about that umpire?
What about him?
Broncos.
Molly, what sucks. About... What about... Yeah, you know, I didn't get a start tonight. You're bloody nice. You're unbelievable, Molly Meldrum. Fair dinkum. I always thought Dolly Sutherland was a pants man, but you take the cake. Come here, Rove. Oh.
Never mind, the bring back the hugs.
Some people reckon you're a dickhead. What do you say to those people?
I think they're right.
You think they're what?
Right.
Kerry Ann, you are an old chag, everyone way back. How are you doing?
I have a problem with old.
No. Not as in old as age, but shagging for ages. That's what I'm talking about.
Yeah. The old shagger.
You look bloody gorgeous tonight. There must be a million diamonds on that bugger.
Absolutely, and they're all for you.
Are they all for me, Kerry Ann? Are they all for me, Kerry Ann? Oh, Kerry Ann. Well, there you go. The Logies aren't at all about who won or who lost. It's who's standing at the end of the night. Comrade Reagan, go and get started.
Now, Lady Luck this week. We're in Newcastle, so we've got a Newcastle girl. Here's Lady Luck.
Hello everyone, I'm Charlotte Connell and it is my great pleasure to be your Lady Luck for round 7. Well, what a week. With a nice little win on the Dragons last Sunday, saw our total surge to nearly $6,000 for the kids. And with the footy show here tonight, the test match tomorrow night, where else would you possibly want to be than right here in Newcastle? Thanks again to the great people at 4&20, makers of Australia's greatest pies, for generously donating another $1,000 to play with. I know how much the boys love a 4&20, the great Australian taste. I'm here with Daniel Abraham, who has taken time out of training to talk with me. So Daniel, last weekend against the Roosters, were they a little too strong?
Yeah, they were. They were a good side, the Roosters, and they were the better side on the day. And it was a good yardstick for us and how we're travelling through the year, but the Roosters are definitely the better side last weekend.
Okay, so what about on Saturday night against Canberra? What are your chances?
Yeah, I think we're in a good chance. It should be a good game down there, but Canberra at Bruce Stadium down there are always strong, so we'll go down there confident and hopefully put up a good show.
Great. Okay, thanks, Daniel, and good luck. And now on with the tips. Now, as much as I would love to put the whole lot on the Knights, I better show my patriotism and spread the money around on Australia. They will be way too good for the Kiwis here at Energy Australia Stadium tomorrow night. There you go, the Kangaroos will surely bring some much-needed funds to the sick kids in the Sydney Children's Hospital at Randwick and the Mater Hospital in Brisbane. I'm Charlotte Connell. Have a great weekend. Go the Knights, go the Kangaroos, and remember, it's great to be an overcastering because Lady Luck is on our side. Oh,
welcome back. You have got no idea how far that is.
Robert?
What about Stirling? You couldn't even run about 2 months ago. Now, you are the best advertiser for hip replacement I've ever seen, Peter.
I can get you one if you want one.
Give me about 30
years. All right, now it's time for what?
Mars Hyundai. Fantastic sponsor.
Yeah, great sponsor.
Thanks once again, Hyundai. Well done. Thank you.
Welcome to that time of the night where we search high and low for the cream of Australian entertainment. It's the footy show's No Talent Time. And when you're talking no talent, who better to introduce than you, fat man? Do your best, bud.
Welcome back. Time for No Talent Time. We're hanging in there. We'll get through this show. We've got a special guest judge for you tonight, an international star. She burst onto the scene a few years ago with an album, Not That Kind. Since then, she has sold 10 million albums around the world. They call her the little one with the big voice. Please, a big Newcastle welcome for Anastasia. Hello there, darling. How are you? Love to see you. No,
do.
No, you're going to stand here for a minute
right.
And have a chat to the fat. What's doing?
Wow.
You like that?
Yeah.
No. Now.
What's that?
No, what is that? Is that like that?
I don't know. They were doing it to me, so I'm doing it back.
Okay. This is good, I think.
No, it's all good. It's all good.
Now, are you having fun in Australia?
I am having a blast. I just did like a 2.5-hour drive to get here.
Yeah, it's just out of Sydney, yeah.
It's just down the street.
Just north. That's a short drive.
Yeah, not bad.
Here you are performing at the Logies on Sunday night. Did you enjoy the Logies?
I loved it.
Yeah.
I loved it.
And this song, is this one of your favourites?
It is. I'll do it if they like it. I don't care.
Really? Who's your favourite artist in the world at the moment? Who do you like listening to?
In the world?
Yeah.
Wow, that's deep. I don't know. That's a deep...
Would it be, say, Kiss or Aerosmith or something
sure,
like that?
Sure, right there. Both of them. Yeah, okay. There you go.
Excellent work.
Exactly what I was going to say. Yeah.
Can I ask Anastasia, what do you think of rugby league?
Like hello, that? Anastasia. My brother just wanted to know if you're married or not, you know what I mean?
No.
Oh, well, let me introduce you. Anastasia, this is Barjas. Barjas, Anastasia.
Well, look, you're going to be our... This is a segment called No Talent Time. The people coming on have absolutely no talent. You're going to be our guest judge for the night. If you can make your way to chair 93, that'd be very good. Anastasia!
Ah,
Yeah, sneaky creep.
Oh, you guys.
I don't know what they call him to you now. I don't
know. All right, what do I do with these blue cards?
So what do you make?
Oh, I'm supposed to know these things. Sure. Why don't we just learn it on air, huh?
You're a good head.
Okay.
Very, very good. You sit there and enjoy yourself. Boys, calm down. Also on Saturday, the Raiders take on the Knights. Joey, Knights, what's doing?
Oh, the boys played great last week. Depends how the guys back up from the test, but with Ruben Wiki being out, I think the boys will win this week for sure.
We've got a few people to thank. We want to thank the people here at the Newcastle Entertainment Centre. Yeah. Thank you very much. We want to thank the people down at the Crown Plaza where we're staying. Thank you very much. We want to thank Andrew Johns.
Yeah. He's a good kid.
He's a good kid, fan. He's a good kid.
We want to thank you people for coming along.
This amazing crowd.
Yes. Yeah.
The Footy Show, brought to you by Hyundai, the cars that let you have it all. And Earth Lava, the new thing to eat if you lived on Mars.
In Canberra, a Brad Drew field goal put the Raiders ahead by 7 points heading into the death of the match. But the Knights got to within one, halfback Kurt Gidley scoring, Clinton Schifovski saving the Raiders. Knights number six Michael Witt failing from close range to send the match into golden point time. Raiders coach Matthew Elliott literally left speechless.
That was a couple to go, and we thought if it was level, you know, it gives us a chance in the game to go and win it.
Now, Falcon, hello, Jim.
Hey. Mate.
Mario Fenech. Little Sting performed on you last week up at Newcastle, I believe.
Blokes, and at the end of the day, it's not funny, I can tell you that.
Well, we think
I'm
it will
doing
be funny.
A Falcon meets the family, and it's a good piece, and then it all went wrong.
Okay, what happened? What happened? We sent Mario to do his normal bi-weekly piece with the families, you know. Last week he went out with the Gidleys, wanted to meet the Gidley family. So we sent him up, and we might have just had a hidden camera there.
G'day, I'm in Newcastle. I'm outside the house of Maddie and Kurt Gidley. Inside the house at the moment, Mario's doing his segment, Falcon Meets the Family. Now, what Mario doesn't know is that a reenactment of a harmless game of backyard footy is about to go horribly wrong. Everybody's in on this, including the Knights coach, Michael Hagan. Everybody's in on it, except the Falcon, that is. Just watch this. This is dead set going to be absolutely hilarious.
Now, this is the famous front garden of the Gidleys. Now, they tell me many a battle was won and lost here. And the making and the talent all came from here. Now, you know the Falcon played a lot of backyard footy too, brother.
Right, let's have a game then, Muzz. You got time for a quick game?
I'll have a... I'm always ready for a rumble, mate. Me. Boys, let's kick off backyard footy, all right? Now, all two right, against mate. One. I'm outnumbered. There you go.
Quick.
Oh, sorry, mate. Smoking zone. Is he serious? He's doing me up. Geez, you're tough, mate. Are
you serious or not?
Yeah, my ankle.
It's the bad one I had last year.
Are you serious? Oh, no. He's hurting himself. Mate, I didn't even tackle him hard.
Doesn't matter, mate.
He ran at me. What can I do? I just nudged him.
Quick.
It's an accident. I've done nothing. Mate, turn around and let me have a look at it.
Nah.
Mate, just take the sock off.
Nah, you're not a doctor.
I know I'm not a doctor, but I've had
the same. Not a kid's home, mate. Mate, he's hagged about it all. Because, we're doing that thing for the footy show at home this morning. And he's doing a bit of backyard footy. Muzz has leaned on Kurt's ankle and... Looks like he's done
something. Muzz is leaning on Kurt's ankle.
No.
The story's changing now.
So,
lean on his ankle.
Do you want to speak to him or?
What are you talking about?
You stepped on my ankle.
I didn't step on your ankle. Do you think I meant it deliberately to hurt the bloke? It's an accident.
Oh, Mario, you're stressing a bit.
Well, of course I'm stressing. That's better, mate. Is that better view or not?
Yeah. Oh, this is frightening.
I hardly did anything. Oh, this is good, mate. This is good.
How long
ago? 6 weeks. 6 weeks. We got insurance. We got insurance, mate. Channel 9 got insurance. The parents aren't even talking to me. They're filthy on me.
He's Hakes.
Is that Hakes?
Oh. Hakes.
Oh, this is mate. Him.
Mate, Kurt's bloody hurt his ankle doing a thing with the footy show. Well, we were just sort of mucking around at the front and Muzz sort of tackled him and I'll put you on one of these guys, mate. Here. Mate, you want to speak to him? He just wants to know what's going on.
Hey, is it?
Yeah.
Hello, mate.
Yeah, what's going on, mate?
Mate, let me say this to you. We've just done a fabulous...
I don't care what you were doing. You shouldn't have had him mucking around in the first place.
Yeah, he's just twisted his ankle, mate.
What? What do you mean?
Mate, if you could see what happened, mate, it was nothing.
How hard did you tackle him? What were you doing?
Champion, I've tackled him. I've hardly touched him. Mate, it's not a major injury, mate. Trust me.
So, what are you, a doctor now, Mario?
No, I'm not a doctor.
Mario, how would you know what sort of injury he's got?
No, but, mate, I am qualified because I've seen ankles before. It's just a major injury. Well, how can I guarantee you 100% he can play on Saturday? Mate, I'm not a doctor. I know, mate. I'm going to put you on the rope. Yeah.
Mate, you'll be hearing from the club and our legal people. We're not happy at all.
He's filthy.
Matt.
I can't believe it.
Hey, Muzz, what's happening?
Matt, you wouldn't believe it. What? The luck I've had, brother. We met the family, the Gidley family.
Because Hayes called me up. He said, it's been drama.
No, he just
look
at it. He fell over.
He's look. Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah.
Hello? What are you doing?
It's a fool. Yeah, get up and have a run. Get up and have a run. Just have a run on it. Yeah.
It's not too bad.
It's a
G-up,
mate.
That's not funny, seriously. I've got the mother not talking to me, the father not talking to me. Oh, it's very funny, isn't it? Oh, lovely. That's not funny.
Come here.
Hey, brother, I'll get square with you.
Hook, line and sinker.
I'll get square with you. I've been got again, mate.
You've
I've been got again.
Beazzled.
Why they think it's funny is beyond me, champion.
Nice work, mate. But you showed a lot of care, a lot of passion and...
hang on, what do you mean a lot of care, a lot of passion? A couple of quotes here.
I hardly touched him.
Matty, the luck I've had. What about Kurt? And your best one, he hurt himself.
What about? Oh, I am qualified. I've seen plenty of sore ankles.
He tore strips off me, Michael Hagan. He tore strips off me.
Thanks, Falcon. And thanks to the Gidley family.
Ben Kennedy, of course, would love to be out there, and we'll see if he can get himself on Friday, of course, to get a couple of games under his belt before they pick the New South Wales State of Origin side. His coach is Michael Hagan, and he's standing by downstairs with Russell Fairfax.
Well, Michael Hagan, if losing Andrew Johns isn't enough now, Ben Kennedy's gone.
Yeah, BK just not quite right at this stage, and you know we just can't afford to risk him given the amount of football he's got to look forward to. So, you know, I think we're probably on the safe side this week, and you know, he'll be hopefully 100% in the next week or two.
Reshuffled the side?
I guess effectively it's the same group of people that played in Canberra, so you know, we've had the benefit of another week together, and probably expected that he may withdraw later in the week, so you know, I think the players have prepared knowing that that might be the case.
Currently in 10th position, Mike. It's a must-win game. You do have to stay in touch with that top eight.
Yeah, it's an important game for us, and I think you know, the players have been applying plenty of effort the last two or three weeks, but you know, no question that we need to try and bounce back and get on the winners list, and you know, today's a good opportunity for us to do that.
Against the desperate Rabbitohs, what's the key?
Well, I guess it's just to focus on us at the moment and you know, really trying to get the confidence of our younger players, and I'm pretty happy with how they're going, but you know, we just need to learn how to win games.
Good luck.
Thank you.
Let's take a look at this Newcastle lineup for this game against the South Sydney Rabbitohs. There is that one change in the forward pack. Todd Lowry comes off the bench and moves into the second row with Abraham slotting back to the lock forward position. And the bench now is Parsons, Matt Kennedy, Price and Ennis.
It's still a strong Newcastle outfit. They've got some key players in the back line. O'Davis, Matty Gidley, Kurt Gidley in the half position. But their forwards, that's their strength offensively. But defensively, that's an area they have to improve. They've conceded more tries than any other team through the middle in the competition, so that's an area they've got to tighten up in.
It's time now for the toss. Let's go downstairs to the captains, Danny Medeiros and Brian Fletcher, with our referee tonight, Shane Hain.
Danny, you're the home side. You call, Brian.
Tails, mate.
Tail it is, mate. Tail it is. What do you want to do?
We'll kick off.
You're going to kick off? Which way do you want to run, Danny?
We'll run away.
All right, best of luck, boys.
Danny, I've got to say, taking over the captaincy of the side, it could be the kiss of death. Ben Kennedy, Andrew Johns.
Yeah, it's a bit like that, but you know, we're improving each week. We want to work on that again today, and you know, we'll see how we go.
No doubt they'll be looking to stop you.
Yeah, it's you know, around the ruck, it's always an important area of a game. So you know, we want to do the same to them. I think watching their reserve grade, they do a lot of running out of dummy half. So I'd probably go into first grade as well.
The key for a win today?
I think just kick early and really put the pressure on them and you know, don't force the footy.
Good luck.
Thanks, Russ.
As the players shake hands, let's go downstairs to our sideline eye, Russell Fairfax.
And joining me is Danny Medeiros, captain of the Knights. Danny, I've got to say, it wasn't a pretty win, but a win nonetheless.
Yeah, no, we got the 2 points. It's pretty ordinary from us tonight. And, you know, we're looking on improving. In the first half, we come up with no intensity, and we turned around big in the second half.
Yeah, real scratchy first half.
Very scratchy first half. Mate, there's no excuse we didn't turn up to play at the start. And, no, we couldn't get into a rhythm, and we got there in the second half.
I've no doubt Michael Hagan, the coach, would have spoke about intensity at halftime. Certainly picked up second 40.
Yeah, we wanted to start the second half well, and no, we kicked off, and a few of our kickoff sessions were pretty good. So, you know, we'll turn up next week.
Thanks very much.
Thanks, Russell.
Well, Robbie O'Davis, welcome back, Robbie. What a performance. You must be pleased. That must be the best for 2004.
Yeah, mate, all around the park we just played so well. Personally, I thought, you know, these old legs might have a little bit more run left in them, so let's hope they keep on going for a little while longer.
Gee, Robbie, you can score a try against South Sydney. Something like 4 in the last 3 games.
Oh, fair thing. I was unaware of that. Maybe I'll just like playing South. I don't know.
You like backing up Medeiros, I know that.
Yeah, that was his try. You know, he called the play before we went, and I was just lucky enough to be alongside him. Mate, personally, the way we've been going all year, I think, you know, to get home and get the reward in front of our crowd after trying so hard for so long with the injuries we've had, you know, I'm just glad we could do it here today.
Robbie, so important you stay in touch with our top eight, and this win has done that.
Yeah, it has, I think. We just have to keep on rolling from here. Doesn't get any easy from now on. We've got Bulldogs at home next week, so let's hope we can prepare ourselves. No injuries, and hopefully we'll have BK back, and you know, he's a big boost for us, and we'll just come back here again next week and do it all over.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Robbie O'Davis and Danny Medeiros with Russell Fairfax. The Knights scored 3 tries to win it in the end. Robbie O'Davis grabbed one of them. They win 24 points to 8. We will take a break and come back to wrap it all up from Energy Australia Stadium.
I did catch up
Chief
with,
was up there.
Yeah, caught up with Mick Hagan and a few of the boys after the game.
Working beautifully.
Sure. All right, Coach, what did you make of that game?
Very unattractive first 40 minutes and obviously improvement in the second half. And I thought our good players were good. The difference between getting the points and not getting the points. I thought Danny Medeiros and Robbie O in particular were very good for us. And, you know, players responded in the second half a bit better.
You know, when this body of mine's fit, I don't sort of... everything seems to be really comfortable. So, and it's fit at the moment. And just everything fell into place, luckily, for us, I suppose, for me tonight.
You know, playing against South, they really chance their arm, and you don't lock the offloads up, and you know, you're up against it all night. So you know, and they got quick play of the balls, and you know, they can hurt some teams. So if you don't match them enthusiasm, you're not halfway there.
Pretty disappointing. We were in it till half time or a bit after. You know, we went in leading 8-6, and then a couple of things didn't go our way, and we sort of fell off the pace, and they ran in a couple of tries. So very disappointing.
Always seems as well for you guys, there's always something external happening too at the same time. Again, hard to focus, or we just get on with the job?
No, the boys put their heads in and just get on with the job. You know, we don't read the papers too much or or listen to what the media has to say.
Next email is from Brad Hector, who was asked to see a Jamie Ainscough field goal for Newcastle in 1995 against Wests at Campbelltown. Now, it gave the Knights a last-second win.
Ross it was. Tracy, now they'll run a... Now it's Ainscough with a shot for field goal. It's close. It's there.
Oh, my God.
It's kicked by Jamie Ainscough. Jamie Ainscough has landed the one-pointer that will seal a remarkable comeback for Newcastle.
While in Newcastle, the Knights steamrolled Souths in a second half win, 24 points to 8.
Newcastle Knights back at it. Their season record now stands at 4 wins, 4 losses. Good news today with representative for Josh Perry cleared of a broken forearm. The Knights came from behind against Souths, trailing 8-6 at half-time, but in the end, experience and class overcame the battered Rabbitohs. Their season stance, 2 wins, 4 losses.
We won the Wooden Spoon last year, and then to lose 16 players right this moment, it's much harder for us than if the Roosters lost 16 players.
Yeah, thanks, Pete. Watching those big hits just takes you back to my career, you know, fantastic. Getting hammered like that every week. All right, Chief, now you've, Chief, of course, assistant country coach. What's doing, champ? Good week,
mate,
for you?
Mate, been a great week. We'll probably talk more about it later on, but we've been to Armidale. Both teams have been up to the country, but it's been...
You enjoyed yourself at the team photo, obviously.
Gee, look excited.
Well, you know, just... Just checking out, make sure everyone's watching.
Looking
one of the boys. Oh, big smile. Love the team photo. It's been a great camp, and we're looking pretty darn good. Don't worry about that.
As assistant coach, when the team runs out tomorrow night, what do you think will be the last thing you say to the boys?
Oh, nothing, hope.
Because your record's not good.
This is a setup. No, I'll probably keep a bit quiet. Maybe at halftime, if they're going okay, I might a couple little words. Maybe,
all right,
maybe.
Nice.
Now, that's tops.
Matty Reg Trent. Mate, Reg, of course, last year was conditioning coach.
He was official conditioner of country, and then was elevated to Blues conditioner. Well, Fatty's at it again this year.
He's at it again with both the city and country sides. Here's Reg.
That's right, I don't like stabbing people in the back, but Harry gets more than 3, boys.
Let me tell you, I know he just stands around like a statue, but the less he says, the better, okay? It's when he starts talking, you know you're in trouble. Hey, Chief? Chief, how are you, mate?
Hello, mate.
Just telling the boys what a great player you was.
Oh, cheers.
No, no problem, mate.
Take your time.
Gaylord.
That Mark Brunel, do you agree he needs to lose some weight?
Nah, he's going all right. Oh, he's not going all right. He's a pig. He only plays 15 minutes every game. He's a cat. You hear that, Riddell? A cat.
What about that? I was over there talking to him. Geez, wasn't he all smug-like? I said, what are you going to do, Riddell? And he said, oh, knock his head off his shoulders. What do you get to say about that? All right, hope he has a good game. I can bloody kill him.
Me favourites. Geez, you've been scoring some tries this year, Amos, haven't you?
Yeah, no, it's going all right.
Oh, it's going all right. It's going all right. Don't be so bloody modest. Al Mazur's not going to be very modest. You're going to give Hazem spasms, son.
Do you hate city people? Do you hate city people, Amos? Do you hate city people, Amos?
You know what worries me about you blokes? You know what? Is we're all sitting around playing cards, and the country boys, they're out there busting their guts on the training field. Not used to sitting there having your lattes and your Gatorades. They're drinking grog! Grog! They're real men. You all smell of Armani and bloody brute. They stink of beer and BO.
How funny was it when I was sitting on the lounge and the night that bloke's knee went, Andrew Times, how funny was it? And the lung. Everyone wrote just straight away, naughty. I said, we're back, son. We're back in the big time.
You're not a beach bum, though, are you?
You're not a beach bum because the blokes who play for the country are rugged and they're tough. Are you tough?
That's all
right. Do you hate city folk?
Bloody
do you
mate.
Hate city folk?
Bloody
a little bit more conviction.
Have a drink, son. Dude, put hairs on your ass.
Yeah, Morgan Morrison, you're a cat, Morrison.
Let's say it, Peter. Oh,
yeah, you're a cat. You're a cat.
Say it again.
I can't say it, mate.
You make a great team, mate.
Mate, we've been doing a lot on defence too.
Hey, what?
We've been doing a lot on defence. I just want to show you a little bit of an example. All right, boys, where's our defence? Statue?
Here, yeah, boys.
Jump into it.
Oh, my
God. I couldn't see him really smiling for once, did you?
Hey, you think that's funny, do you?
No, no, no.
Is that brute you're wearing?
As long as you're okay.
No, I'm okay.
What's the plan?
Thanks for joining us in the camp. I really appreciate it. I mean, the guys really get a rev out of a legend, the person who's been there and done it all.
Oh, look, this guy, Sebastian. Oh, God, Sebastian. Sing me a song, guy. Sing me a song. Oh, haven't I sing you a song, guy? Oh, thank God I'm a country boy. Yes, take that up, you Stevens. Oh, you grew up in this. You grew up in the country. You grew up in the country.
You're a bloody turncoat, son. How do you feel about that?
Oh, well, you know, it's something you're going to do.
Oh, son, it's not something yet. It's not something yet.
And you, Steve. I just
It'll be country victory. I'm that confident.
Okay, so 2AB around here?
Sure.
Let's go back to Sydney.
5, 6, 7, slow down. 8, 9, 10. No, speed it up. 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. Medium pace. Too slow for it, huh? See that? Yeah. We're up to 38, 9, 40, 1. Quick, come on. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Well done, son. You're ready, aren't you? You're ready.
Well, tomorrow night's game should be a cracker. And worrying if that Cat Harrigan, the so-called assistant coach, keeps his gob shut, the country boys are going to win by 40 points. You beauty, I'm Reg Reagan. Go and get stuck.
Reg was very fired up.
A lot of bad blood between the chief and Reg.
That's a bit of a... That's the drunkest I've ever seen Reg. He must have had half a cart before training.
Been on a bender.
He had a cart and a half of KB. Oh.
Well, still think it's really obvious, but like the reverence and respect he's held, like the players, they look at him, they know he's achieved it. I think it's wonderful that he works for the Footy Show, Reg.
Absolutely. Now, of course, on this Sunday, it's Mother's Day. And of course, Mother's Day, all mothers gearing up for a big one on Sunday. Trent, of course, Trent the flight steward. I'm not sure if Trent had a mum. He might have had two dads.
But
he's been out and about on the streets of Gosford, just checking out what's going to happen on Mother's Day.
Hi guys, Trent here. I'm out of the closet at an errand affair at the heart of the Central Coast. And I'm asking the good people around here what they're going to do for their mothers on Mother's Day.
What are you going to do for your ma on Mother's Day?
Not much.
Who's that brute on that shirt?
Are you Scottish?
What old Scots?
Where's your kilt? Where's your kilt?
I've got the kilt on today.
Oh, if you put it on, I would have gone. Wee-hoo-wee. Look at the
So what are you planning for Mother's Day? What are you going to do for your ma?
I'm actually taking her out for lunch.
Where to?
Pell Beach.
You're a beautiful girl, you know that?
You're quite attractive yourself there.
You got a brother, by any chance? What do you got planned for Mother's Day, Ma?
Oh, nothing special.
Any hanky-panky or anything? Or...
I don't know.
What are you going to do for your Ma on Mother's Day?
Give her lots of presents.
Sorry. Sorry. So what are you going to do for your Ma on Mother's Day?
Give her lots of presents.
Give her sisters.
Really?
You do look alike. You know, anyone told you that?
Yes.
Oh, you're the cutest button.
Oh, you're cute too, Trey.
What about Mitch? You got a message for Mara down the barrel of the camera?
Nah. Happy Mother's Day.
Happy Mother's Day. A little bit more effort, Mitch. I mean, this is the woman that made love to that man. To that wild beast for you. So come on, give that girl a little bit of respect. Isn't that right, Clary?
For sure.
Happy Mother's Day, Mom.
Mitch, you're a good kid.
Mother's Day, Ma.
A little bit more feeling wild, child.
Happy Mother's Day, Ma.
A little bit more feeling wild, child.
Happy Mother's Day, Ma.
A little bit more elocution, wild child.
Happy birthday, Ma. I mean, happy Mother's Day.
Hey, I'm a rose between two thorns. What are you guys going to do for your Ma on Mother's Day?
Probably just a big kiss and a hug.
Gonna show me how that would.
Happy Mother's Day!
Apart from Mardi Gras, Mother's Day is my favorite day of the year. So, all you mums out there, you have a ball. I know I will. And Ma, back in San Francisco, I'll be home soon. Love and kisses.
Days, a man of the people is, Trent.
Now, Mother's Day theme, of course, that happens on Sunday, so make sure you're nice to your mums. And we've got two of our great players in the NRL and their mums joining us. Stephen Menzies, his mum Carolyn. Kurt Gidley, his mum Anne. Welcome. Welcome. First up, Mrs. Menzies, how are you? Good. Now, your son on Sunday plays his 250th first grade game. You must be very, very proud. Did you think he'd play for this long?
No, we didn't think he'd get started.
Yeah. Did you know he was this good when he was a kid?
I'm his mother, Patty. Of course, I thought he was that good. Yeah.
Excellent work. Now, Anne Gidley, what about the sting last week at Mario? That must have been a lot of fun.
It was well done.
Let's go back a week and have a look at the sting by the Gidleys on the Falcon.
Two against one. I'm outnumbered. There you go.
Quick.
Oh, sorry, mate. He ran at me.
Oh, this is good, mate. This is good.
Oh. It's an accident. It's an accident. I've done nothing. What are you doing?
It's a fool. Yeah, get up and have a run. Get up and have a run. Just have a run on it. Yeah.
It's not too bad.
Come on, yeah.
I'll get square with you.
One of the great stings. How did you both not laugh during that 20 minutes that took?
I was only there a few minutes.
Must have been tough, Kurt.
Yeah, it was pretty hard. I was lucky I had a hat on and just kept looking at the ground because every time I looked at him, yeah.
All right then. Well, look, we're going to play mother and son. It's along the lines of perfect partners. We're going to see just how much the sons know about their mothers and the mothers know about their sons. So here we go. We've got 10 questions for you. You've got about 10 seconds to answer each question. Then we'll see how you go at the end of it. All right. What is the boy's worst habit? Everyone has to write down what you think. The boy's worst habit. 10 seconds. And let's... The Menzies, if you can hold them up, please. Very messy and very messy. Oh, yes, there's a match.
That's a
and
match.
The Gidleys, Kurt. Farting, no. Obviously something that your mum doesn't know about yet. All right. What is the nicest thing your son has ever done for you on Mother's Day? What's the nicest thing your son's ever done for you? Anne Gidley is struggling at this stage. Maybe it'll happen this Sunday. We might go to the Gidleys first up, as soon as Kurt stops writing. Right, I've bought flowers and given a present. I think that's a match.
That'll do.
Yep. And the Beavers. Bricky in bed made me breakfast pancakes. Excellent work. Yeah. The Menzies on fire. Everyone knows you can't beat your mum's cooking. What's the boy's favourite meal? Straight into it. They know this one. They got this one right. The Beavers first up. Lasagna. Yep. And the Gidleys. Roast and a baked dinner. That'll be a match.
That's a match.
What date is your mum's birthday? What date's your mum's birthday? The mum should get this right.
Not for the last date? What year she was born or just the first two?
I'm not sure about what year.
No, we'll look at the year.
You might just put the month and the day.
No year.
Yeah. The Gidleys. November 1 and the 1st 11th. Yes, very good. And the Beavers. 16th of June.
It's my birthday.
What was the boy's first pet? And what was its name? What was the boy's first pet? And what was its name?
Slavey.
Kurt, is it possible Kurt might have had a pet you didn't know about? It is, yeah. What's the name of your first pet, Matt?
I had a dog called Beefer, Matt.
Beefer?
He was a Beefer bastard.
Bonnie the Labrador.
Bonnie?
Scotty the Terrier.
I had a...
Scotty.
I had a budgie called Pretty Boy. all right, who are we? Beavers. The Beavers. We've got a dog, forgotten the name, and Boris a bird.
A bird dog.
Massive problems. Go on. Ham and Kurt. Dog lady, yes, excellent work. What is your mum's favourite music? Favourite music?
Oh, boys.
Might be Aerosmith or Nirvana. The Gidleys first up. John Mayer and John Mayer, yep.
Yeah.
And the Beatles, the B-double-E, the Beatles, yep. One of your best people. That'll do. Is that a new band? Are they a new band coming in? The Beatles, right up. Who's mum's favourite TV star? Mum's favourite TV star.
Fat.
Telly Savalas. Rock Hudson.
He's my favourite telly.
Anne is struggling. She doesn't watch a lot of telly.
He's a big one.
Too busy doing other things. The Beavers are right to go, I think. We've got Beaver. Fatty and Robert Redford, that's a match. That is a match.
Robert Redford and Fatty. It's a match.
Fatty and Robert Redford, give him one for that. And the Gidleys have got the ER staff and Dr. Green from ER. Yeah, we'll play that one. Okay. Did the boys cry on their first day of school? Did little Beaver cry? Kurt and Anne, you got an answer there? Anne says no, and Kurt said yes. I don't know what's going to happen here. No and yes. Well, the girls match. The girls won. If the boys weren't football... Oh, this will be good. If the boys weren't footballers, what would they have been? Yeah. Beaver, porno star, maybe?
Porno star.
I've seen him.
The shower.
Stephen, Carolyn.
I'm still riding.
Still riding. All right, go to the Gidleys first. A butcher. There you go. That's right. Because, of course, Matt's a butcher, isn't he?
Yeah, butcher.
Is brother Matt a butcher?
Yeah.
You're a butcher, right?
Yeah.
Oh, true. and the Benzieses? A PE teacher would like to be a pro golfer. Or more likely a stockbroker. That's a bit different to a PE teacher. Pro golfer, he's not far off it. Playing now off three, he's a great golfer, Steve Menzies.
Oh,
what was the name of the boy's first girlfriend? Or maybe boyfriend, I'm not sure. What was the name of the boy's first girlfriend? What was the name of your first girlfriend, Matt? Beaver?
Wayne.
Kurt, struggling. Have you never had one?
Nothing. Still searching for me first, ever.
Fair dig. Beaver, you are. You've got nothing, Beaver.
Can't remember which one come first.
Which one come first? Can't remember which one of the two. Here we go. It started with a K. The Gidleys, you right to go? Kurt, gone. Got nothing?
Time's up.
Glenn, do you remember? Anne? Just hold yours up. Lara, do you remember Lara?
I don't know.
No.
Yeah, no, I do.
Obviously, you didn't, not much happening there. And, just brushed up.
On fire, fat.
And with fifth grade, we got Kieran.
I think it was something, I don't know her name.
Karen. Yeah, what's the match? So, here we go. Mother's Day special, is there a score? 7-0! Yeah. Therefore, That's a tie. We've got something special for you, beautiful young ladies, as the boys sprint off.
Cheaper.
It'll be a big day Sunday, Beaver. 250 games, mate. Well done.
Yeah, looking forward to it. Thanks,
mate. Yeah, it'll be great. Here they go, the boys.
Because I'm going on the 16th of June. And,
You're
the only other person
I've
ever met on the same day.
The father's
the sixth,
but
I'm the
16th. That's why you're so good. I've got
3 sixth cats
on Chandler Beaver's
doing his best.
Yeah, right,
been a while.
Always been a pass man, Pete.
Thank you. Please thank Carol, Anne, Kurt and Steve for us.
And good luck tomorrow night.
Yeah, good luck tomorrow night. As I said, Steve Menzies is a Manly legend. He'll be down there playing against the Dragons on Sunday, so make sure all the Manly fans get down and give him a support. 250 first-grade games. It's a wonderful achievement.
I see we can squeeze a couple of emails in today. Continuing our search for the best tries of the last 25 years, our email address is bootsandall@nine.com.au or write to us at the station, as Damien Cooper has done. Now, he wanted to see a Newcastle try from 1999 against South, and this included some freakish play from the Johns brothers.
Andrew with a little kick. He's looking for the regather. The bounce is important. Oh, he puts a bat on it. Now Craigie puts it inside. Matthew puts it outside. Craigie puts the ball over the shoulder. Then a flick pass. Have a look at this for Razzle Dazzle. Now Andrew puts a kick across. They're going to score. They're going to put it down. They are going to score. That is a miraculous try. That is beautiful. That is entertainment.
Yeah, great try that.
And a huge upset at Newcastle as the Knights hammered the Bulldogs. Patrick Mullahan, 7 News.
Ken Sutcliffe with Sport is next, and the Knights' Danny Baderas wants Andrew John's job.
Yes, he wants to captain the Blues, Jim.
Newcastle's win over the Bulldogs was the third club game Kennedy has missed with a hamstring problem, while stand-in captain Danny Baderas continued to push his claims for the vacant Blues captaincy.
It'll be a great honour, and there's a lot of superb great players in that team, so we'll see what happens there.
This is what Knights coach Michael Hagan had to say about Diego Gidley.
That will go down in the club's history as one of the better front row performances that we've seen. And I'm not sure they actually knew what he was doing when he had the football, but the result was pretty good. I think Woolley scored one off a kick, so... You know, the front rowers of years gone by won't be happy with the new brigade one bit.
Adam Warno in a class of his own now. Now, the Knights' defence has leaked plenty of points in past seasons, and they've given up a few again this season, but not yesterday against the Bulldogs, where they were very good.
Well, they were getting 3 and 4 blokes in every tackle, and they made a lot more tackles in the game, purely and simply because they were getting 3 and 4 blokes into tackles. The Bulldogs were only getting 1 or 2 blokes into tackles, and they were in the faces of the Dogs right through the match. And the Dogs had 20 or 30 tackles down inside the Knights' 20-metre zone, and they couldn't come up with tries. They came up with one try, basically, and they just couldn't convert the points because the Knights were cutting down their think time.
Sport now.
Yes,
now,
Jess?
Now, Tamana Tahu wants to play for the Blues, but they won't let him.
No, they won't, Jessica. He reckons he's fit, but he won't get a chance to prove it.
Newcastle winger Tamana Tahu will miss State of Origin 1, even after declaring himself fit to play. Tony Peters joins us now. Is this a case for an exception to the rule?
Well, Tim, the Newcastle Knights doctor ruled him out of Friday night's match against the Brisbane Broncos with that ongoing hamstring problem. Now, he hasn't played a game of football for 3 weeks when he last played for Australia up in Newcastle against the Kiwis. Now, the 30-man squad assembled today. The final 17 will be named, of course, on Sunday night. Now, Luke Lewis, Amos Roberts and Hazem El Masri now all come into contention for the spot because Tahu can't prove his fitness this weekend. But Tahu believes he's right to play.
Yeah, I'm convinced I won't be playing, but you know, I'm just letting the selectors and the trainers know that I'm 100%, and you know, if I do get selected, I'll be right.
Now, Tone, interesting. Who do you think will captain the Blues?
Well, Tim, the New South Wales Rugby League Board will name him on Monday morning. At this stage, Danny Baderas, Ben Kennedy are fit, and of course Craig Gower are the main contenders.
It's something you dream of doing, and if it got thrown my way, of course you'd do it. But there's so many players that could do the job, so I'm just going to sit back and see what can happen.
Yeah, there's plenty of them. Thanks, Tone.
Kim.
Tony Peters.
Phil Gould's idea of an alcohol-free camp for the Blues State of Origin series is to be dropped, players and coaching staff believing it's not necessary. With the team to be announced on Monday, New South Wales contenders came together today ahead of a vital weekend of club football, which will have a big bearing on selection.
Outside, they arrived in their club groups, But once inside, this preliminary Origin squad forgot all colours, except the sky blue. Barring any injuries this weekend, the New South Wales 17 will come from this group of 30.
Whether we take experience into game one or whether we take match fitness into game one is something we're going to come up with in the next few days.
Tamana Tahu is among those feeling the heat, ruled out by the Newcastle doctor for Friday's game against Brisbane with an ongoing hamstring injury. Tahu would have missed more than a month of football by the time Origin 1 is played. It's a body blow, particularly to a body he says is right to go.
I thought I was 100%. I trained on Monday and my hammy's pulled up pretty good and there's no soreness there.
League might be changing its image, but the old-fashioned ways are good enough for the Blues, with the team to reject an alcohol ban when they go into State of Origin camp. New South Wales, meanwhile, has suffered a setback. Centre Tamana Tahu ruled out with a hamstring injury.
Tamana Tahu got to say hello to a few friends before waving goodbye to Origin 1, the moment he told Blues coach Phil Gould he wouldn't be right to prove his fitness against Brisbane this week.
Play. Go out on Friday night and play and tear my hamstring in the 10th minute or something, then you know, I'm making a goose of myself.
It's opened up a spot on the right wing.
Whether or not we play a Luke Lewis there, who's been playing centre for his club, or maybe even his club winger Amos Roberts or Hazemil Masri as a goal kicker, they may come into reckoning now.
And Gould won't risk carrying players who aren't fit.
Origin 1 has nearly determined the series, and to lose Origin 1 and have to go to Queensland and Origin 2 to square the series is a big ask.
Obviously the player's got to be honest and man enough to not go out and play injured this weekend just to get a start in the Origin.
But Dragons 5'8" Trent Barrett thinks his hamstring will hold up when he returns against the Bulldogs, while Knights skipper Ben Kennedy will be hoping for the same against Brisbane.
I've been out for a month now, so, you know, it's time to play and see what happens.
And Gould's told the squad the test players don't have a mortgage on positions.
I think State of Origin should determine who plays for Australia. I don't think who plays for Australia should determine who plays State of Origin.
Patrick Mullahan, 7 News.
Righto now, we went to Bourke yesterday.
Well, remember a few weeks ago, there was a fantastic sting with the Gidleys on Mario over there. Well, the tradition did continue. We sent Reggie Boy and the Fab went out to Bourke, and it was the Fatty Outback Challenge. Now, we gathered the most annoying man in Bourke and we paid him $50 to follow Fatty around for the whole day. Reggie Boy, have a look at this.
G'day, I'm Reg Reagan, and I'm here at the Fatty Vorden Outback Challenge. And since I've been dragged here kicking and screaming, I thought, hey, why not Reggie Boy have a little bit of fun? And for fun, I've roped in Jamie, and for $50, he's going to annoy the hell out of Fats Vorden for the whole day. Are you up to the task, Jamie?
Yes, I'm up to the task. Yes, and I'm going to have a bit of fun tormenting Fatty all day.
Who can argue with that? Let's get to it.
Let's go. How you going, Fatty?
Yeah, good, mate.
There we go,
mate. How are you, mate? All right.
Good in the council, mate. How's the slide up here, mate?
Good, yeah.
Good?
Up and down.
Bit bumpy?
No, it's fine.
Fine?
Yeah, yeah, it's all good.
This time of year is a good time to come, mate.
Yeah, it's pretty green, actually.
Flies around, mate.
No, it's all good.
Yeah? Just tough tugging your teeth there, mate.
Yeah, I have, actually. I'm just going to go and watch some footy.
How's Sterlo going, mate? What's Sterlo like?
Yeah, he's going well.
Real well? Hey? Them flies look like something annoying, mate. Yeah. Flies are getting annoying there, mate.
Flies are fine, mate. They're not annoying me at all.
What did you used to do, mate, before you played footy in that general?
Working the bank.
Working the bank?
Yeah.
Was it good?
No.
So whereabouts in Sydney do you live at, Pat?
On the northern beaches.
Where's that?
Northern beaches of Sydney.
Where's that?
Manly.
Manly. So that's over the bridge? I'll take it.
Over the bridge, mate.
Come on, Fatty, you don't need that, mate. You can't be a soft out here.
Hey, where's the coppers? There could be an atrocity here in a minute.
Coppers won't be able to help you, mate. They can't get me.
You've dead to come out of the mental asylum. Mate, that bloke was unbelievable. Where do you live? Northern Beaches. Where's that? Manly. Is that north of the bridge? How long's the bridge?
You're not very talkative, mate. Not very talkative. Who's going to win the State of Origin this year, Fatty?
Queensland, mate.
New South Wales are flogging.
Righto.
Queensland's got nothing. Lockie is gone. All the main fellas are gone. Fatty, don't sit there with your back at me, mate.
Mate, listen, mate, please. Mate, you're being a fair dinkum pest, all right? You're a nice bloke, but, mate, you're being a pest. All right?
Well, I'm just like, glad to see you, mate.
Yeah, mate,
don't see you sort of people here very often.
Mate, you're just being a pest.
OK, I'll come and see you later on.
Right, mate, that'd be good.
How bad?
I don't want to be rude, but fair dinkum. You know what I should have done? I don't know, mate.
You don't know?
I don't know, mate.
You don't know? Why not?
Mate, I've... They should, like, right now, they should take us away to the pub for an hour and come back just for the grand final.
Come on, Fatty, mate, like, you know, I've been waiting for you to come out here all this time, telling people.
Yeah, mate, that's terrific, turning around but I don't want to spend 5 hours with you, you know what I mean? There's a thousand questions.
I think I'm being quite generous.
Mate. It's terrific to meet you, but, you know...
There's no need to get uptight, mate.
Oh, it's killing me. Mate, I'm not getting uptight. Just give us a break.
Breathe easy, mate.
Give us a break,
easy.
Will you?
Give you a break. I'm only asking several questions.
Yeah, I know they are. They're very simple.
You can't even answer them for me. What are we going to do, Fatty?
When?
You going to sign some autographs, mate? How many of them a day do you sign, Fatty?
A lot today.
A lot today? Thousands?
You'd be like a hemorrhoid. You just keep coming back. He's getting to me, I'll tell you.
Getting well, mate?
Yeah, I'm going all right. Yeah, where are we? Over here? Sweet.
There's something to tell you, mate. This bloke is not only the world's biggest pest, but he's a wonderful actor as well.
Oh, that will do on you, mate.
That will do. Are you serious? That's been a fair get. Fat, as usual, showed patience.
You were patient, weren't you?
Very patient.
Wasn't
it? Yeah. It took a while for you to get me.
Words in there, mate.
You're lucky I'm a nice bloke, otherwise a dead set, I could have cut loose on you.
Well, the reason we blew it up is that Fats said to me in the toilet, he said, mate, fair dinkum, he said, I can put up with him so long. He said, I think I'm about to knock him out.
Yeah, mate, yeah.
Good on you. Excellent. Put it there. Yeah, they got me good.
Hey, boys.
I was very patient.
Who is that bloke? He's
Jamie,
the best pestosaurus in the world.
From out of,
well, you know what?
Yeah. He's a copper out there in Bourke, actually.
And a good bloke. I mean, he's a fantastic actor. Yeah. I mean, he's just a dead salmon.
Mate, I've got to give him an
MVP. Good on you, Jamie. Had me going, Chet. So hung in there for a while.
How long is the Harbour Bridge?
I got no idea, mate. Falcon, did you enjoy that?
Well, now you know what I felt like. Fact. Not much fun, is it, Fat?
No, it was great fun. I had a ball. It was great out there in Bourke. And by the way, the rest of that Bourke story, the Fatty Vorton Outback Challenge, be a big story on that next week, in case you're up there in Bourke.
Excellent.
Wondering what happened. But all the kids played, and it was won by Walgett on the day, and we had a great day out there, didn't we?
Oh, I did. Rich, there was some great young players out there too, Fat. And there's some great actors out there too.
And he's a local cobber.
Oh, he'll be the local hero out there now.
That's great.
Got me good. It was a great day.
OK, now, have the Broncos kept those 2 points from the Tigers game?
We'll know the answer to that one on Monday, Tim, but more immediately, the Broncos face the Newcastle Knights tonight. Of course, Andrew Johns is up in Brisbane helping out the Newcastle Knights, especially the young 5'8 Steve Witt, who, of course, has filled the breach in recent weeks and will continue to do so. Now, the other point that comes out of this is that both sides are coming off very good wins last week, surprise wins, but the Knights, of course, were the side that spoilt the homecoming for the Brisbane Broncos last year to Suncorp Stadium in this game last year.
Those things that if you've had a good experience at a ground, that can certainly help your confidence a little bit. So, you know, I think they're looking forward to the fact that Suncorp's a great venue and it'll be a great atmosphere like it was last year.
Most of their players have played 2 or 3 times at our ground, so and we have now, and it's starting to feel more like a home ground. Last year was our first game. We were really excited, just like every team coming.
Tim Sheridan with Sport is next. And can the Knights do it again against the Broncos?
Yes, Jim, they take on Brisbane tonight and we'll speak live with Newcastle coach Michael Hagan after the break. Friday night football is in Brisbane with the Broncos hosting the Knights, who are on a high following their thumping win over the Bulldogs last week. And with halfback Kurt Gidley starring in the absence of Andrew Johns, suddenly Newcastle has again emerged as a premiership threat. And their coach Michael Hagan joins me now. Michael, thanks for your time. You've beaten the Bulldogs. Tonight it's Brisbane at home. Would a win here prove the Knights are a genuine force this season?
Yeah, I guess that's what we're looking for, given that we're sitting about sixth at the moment. We know Brisbane are right among the best teams, like Canterbury were last week, and it's just a really important game for us tonight, just for this weekend, but also for the season, generally speaking.
In your experience with Ben Kennedy, what does his return mean for your side tonight?
I think he's very important to us, given that some of the young players have been doing a very good job in his absence, but he drives the team along, very inspirational in what he does, and he'll captain the team pretty well tonight, I think.
And what about young Kurt Gidley's form? As a coach, you've got to be sleeping a bit better these days.
No, I think he's done a real good job for us at halfback in the absence of Andrew Johns. Did a pretty good job at the end of last year, I thought, and he's carried that form into the start of this season, and he's leading the team and showing them around the park pretty well. So, he's getting better all the time, and we're lucky to have him in such good form.
Michael, thanks for joining us, and good luck tonight.
Thank you.
And you can see all the action of that one on Nine at 8:30.
State of Origin contenders will get one last chance to impress selectors this weekend before the final squad's chosen. Tonight's Knights-Broncos match features 11 Origin hopefuls from both sides of the border, plus a coach with a foot in both camps.
With the State of Origin series around the corner, tonight's match raises some interesting conflicts of interest, and Michael Hagan is right in the middle of it. Wearing his Knights hat, he's encouraging Blues contenders like Ben Kennedy, who's back from injury.
He knows he needs to get some football played if he's to be considered for Origin too. So, that's probably a good sign for him and good sign for the team.
But as Queensland coach, his presence at Suncorp Stadium will be a trigger for Brisbane's Maroon hopefuls to step up. And that causes problems for the Knights.
They're impressed as well. Brisbane are, for Queensland selection. So, they're always hard at Brisbane. Plus it's added pressure for them, I suppose.
The Hagan conundrum kicks off round 10. Tomorrow, the Dragons host the Bulldogs, the Sharks face the Roosters, and Souths tackle the Cowboys. Sunday, it's the Warriors and Manly, the Tigers home to Canberra, and Parramatta against Melbourne.
Matt Gidley brings it away from the 10, crosses the 20, takes it out to the 30-metre line. Good metres, but of course you must understand that these players are so tired, they can't put much of a chase on the kick anyway. Craig Hall, a couple of metres on their side of halfway, Carroll and Maguire, the tacklers, Badiris, off to Kurt Gidley, standing, offloading, picking up Woolnough, taken by Carroll and Carlaw, play just inside the Brisbane 40-metre line. Badiris, away to Ennis, Ennis in jumper, 70, does well.
Kurt Gidley's to the right, 30
he is
out.
Indeed, he gives himself plenty of depth, gets the kick away.
It's over!
I think it's cleared
it's
the
over.
Bar! It's cleared the bar! It's a point! Newcastle has won it! Kurt Gidley, he kicks a freak of a goal! It has just got over the crossbar! Incredible kick! It was just about the worst drop kick you've ever seen, but it clambered over the bar. The Knights have won it, 17-16.
There was a boarding room scrape of butter in that one. But the direction was good, the height was good enough. And what an effort by this team to get home tonight. Incredible adversity they faced. Look at it, it's a shocker, but it's beautiful.
Kurt Gidley has that capped a magnificent period in his career. Look at Michael.
He wasn't sure. Yo-ho! Yes! Got it!
Oh, scenes the like of which this new stadium has not yet seen. And look at the anguish, the expectation. It the bloke with the beard of saying, no, it didn't go over. No way, no one did it go over. Kurt Gidley wearing the famous number 7 jumper. Almost as though
A touch of magic rides with that famous jumper. Matt Johns is with Kurt Gidley.
All right, Kurt, what about that, mate?
Unbelievable. It's probably one of the best games this year, I suppose, on the real side.
Mate, yeah. We can forgive you for that, mate.
Yeah, I'm speechless, mate. I didn't strike at the best, but it got there anyway.
Best game you ever played in?
Yeah, for sure. You know, this time, exact same time last year, opening their ground, it was a great game.
Talk us through the kick, Kurt.
Oh, mate, I don't know. I tried one early and it got charged down, and then I just thought, I'll try it again, mate, nothing to lose. And I didn't strike at the best, but it just made it, so I was stoked.
When it left the boot, you think it was going over?
I knew it was going straight. I just didn't know whether it had the legs, and unfortunately it did.
You got the legs, mate. You're the hero of the hunter. Good on you, Kurt.
Thanks, mate. Thanks, mate.
Kurt Gidley, he was a butcher by trade. He's now a full-time professional footballer, and he's one hell of a footballer. He's just put the final chop, the final carve-up on the Broncos, who played so well. There were some beautiful moments in this game. It's been described there by Kurt as probably the best game of the season and the best one he's played in. His brother Matthew congratulating him. It has been a fabulous night. And as Wayne Bennett probably has pointed out in the past, it's a shame that we have to break the deadlock. But Newcastle win a golden pointer here at Suncorp as we ask you and remind you to stay with us for the post-match wrap with Sterlo, Matthew Johns, Andrew Voss and Nine's Friday Night Football continuing after this.
What a night here at Suncorp Stadium. What a night for young Kurt Gidley to kick the first field goal of his first grade career in Golden Point extra time and a 17-16 victory by the Newcastle Knights over the Brisbane Broncos. Coincidentally, the first Golden Point extra time game last year was in round 10. Manly beat Parramatta. Our first Golden Point extra point game on a Friday night is round 10, 2004. Three tries all, but you only got to go to the bottom line. That's what won it, and that was all the difference between the two sides. Peter Sterling, Matthew Johns, you can be a bit biased. I think the Queensland viewers would excuse you having a little bit of Knights bias tonight.
It's great to be an Avocastrian.
They rated last week one of the best wins in the history of the club. What about tonight?
Well, it's up there, Vossie. Don't add it. When you consider they lose Hughes early, Kennedy early, and Kennedy's a real driving force. It is. It's just one of the great wins. But as you said from the top, just a great game as well.
Yeah, it's hard to... It's almost cruel to dissect the match now, Peter, and say, you know, one side lost it.
Yeah, well, first up, I want to congratulate the 32 players. That's all due respect to the players who missed out in Kennedy and Hughes. For the spectacle they put on tonight, it was just a magnificent game of rugby league. Look, it went to Golden Point, but that's not necessarily where the game is won. It was won earlier by the Knights in certain areas, maybe best exemplified by Matt Parsons coming through and charging down. Casey Maguire's kick, he hit it pretty well. You know, a lot of turning points in this game, a lot of areas before that Golden Point kick where Newcastle helped to win the game.
Yeah, what emphasises about the players missing tonight, you can make almost a composite test side out of the players that are unavailable.
Look, definitely. And I thought the Broncos tonight, they dominated through long periods, but I thought they just lacked the firepower to get the ball across the line. That's where they miss Lockyer. I mean, Lockyer handles 80% of the quality possession. When he's not there, that's a huge hole in the team.
All right, let's go down to our man of the match. Chris Bombalis is in the tunnel with our Nutrigrain Iron Man of the match.
Our $1,000 Nutrigrain Iron Man of the match is the Knights captain in Danny Badiris. Budsy, well done. What a game of football.
It was a great game of footy. You know, we just stuck in there. We had a couple of men down too. So, you know, we didn't want that extra golden point to go too long. So it only went for a couple of minutes.
What about that field goal? I know it's only worth a point and two premiership points, but how much is it worth to the club?
Yeah, it's great. You know, we've got a buy next week and we're sitting all right. It's been a great team effort over the last, you know, month or so. So, you know, everyone involved is pretty proud of the way we've been going.
And for you personally, a great lead into State of Origin, which is just around the corner.
Yeah, that's as tough as they come. And, you know, hopefully on Monday getting the side and getting into camp and, you know, get there and have a good week.
Do you have any sympathy for the Broncos? I mean, neither side, when you go through a game like that, deserves to lose, do they?
It is. It's like a knockout fight, you know. It's... You know, they had chances to win it, we had chances to win it, and, you know, it's a toss of dice at the end.
Well, congratulations. Here's $1,000 from Channel 9 and Nutrigrain.
Thanks, Nutrigrain and Channel 9. Thanks, Brian.
Classy stuff indeed from Stu Kelly and Gordon Taylor speaking to us. Obvious disappointment there for the Broncos. They won a game in Golden Point extra time last year against the Melbourne Storm. Didn't get the result tonight. We're going to take a break right now on our post-match show, Channel 9's Friday Night Football, a night where Newcastle have beaten Brisbane by 17 points to 16. And after the break, straight down to the Knights dressing room to hear from the winners. Nine's Friday Night Football. Now ride this kick with Kurt Gidley. Ride it with a Newcastle coach, Michael Hagan. This is in Golden Point extra time. Ball is going. It scrapes over the crossbar. Up go the arms of Kurt Gidley. In fact, some Magpie fans watching tonight will probably remember a similar kick by Andrew Willis some years back against North Sydney at Campbelltown. A kick that has scraped over the bar by no more than a centimetre. Then it is loving time. Plenty of loving there for the Newcastle Knights, and why not? Everyone wants a hug. Kurt Gidley's got the field goal. I don't think he can believe it. Michael Hagan, the coach, I don't think could believe it. But Newcastle, on the back of that, two hard-earned, probably no hard-earned competition points they will have all this year, a 17 points to 16 victory. Well, Bomber has made his way across to the Newcastle dressing room right now. Bomber, it's all yours.
Well, after a breathtaking win, obviously it is a buoyant Newcastle dressing room. It's tempered a little bit, though, by injuries to Ben Kennedy. That hamstring's gone again, and it looks like he's out of State of Origin 1. And, of course, Mark Hughes has also done a hamstring, but the good news for him is a bye next week, and he should be fit for the week after. Joining us now is Matthew Gidley. And, Matt, what a way to win a football game.
Yeah, it's all fairly exciting. I mean, you know, you'd like to win it in the original 80 minutes, but, yeah, no, it's a tough way to lose the game, but... although it was a shonky old field goal got over, so we're really happy.
Well, your side created a few opportunities and you gave a bit of space to Craig Hall, who got over for a couple of tries.
Yeah, I thought Hawley was tremendous for us tonight. Probably the last 4 or 5 weeks, he just keeps improving, and he's definitely been one of our better players this year, for sure.
Both sides obviously had half a dozen players out. A lot of guts, Shane.
Yeah, I mean, we're both in a similar boat as far as injuries go. But, you know, a lot of teams are in that boat this year, and you've still got to turn up on the day and try and get the 2 points for your club. So both teams worked really hard tonight, and I'm just really proud of the boys. You know, we keep improving as a team, and they're all willing to put in during the week and starting to show on the weekend.
Congratulations. Enjoy the weekend off, and good luck with Origin selection.
No worries. Thanks, Bob.
There he is, Matthew Gidley, and joining us now is the coach. You're a card player at the best of times, in the same mould as Wayne Bennett, but is there some reaction from the coach tonight after that?
Oh, I think anyone that watched the game that loves rugby league and a bit of excitement, I mean, I was excited as anybody when that field goal went over, and it was just a great result for our club, and you know, it's disappointing for a team to lose in those circumstances, and you know, we probably missed a couple, and they were in shape to do something to us, so it was just a fantastic game, and we're pleased to be on the winning end of it.
Well, you must be going into State of Origin on an emotional high as the Queensland coach.
Oh, I think, you know, we've been in this situation for a number of weeks with our club, and the boys have been really turning up and putting their hand up. A couple of injuries, a couple of guys not there, and couldn't be happier or prouder with the effort of the team.
Well, put your Queensland cap on quickly. How do you lift some of the blokes in the other dressing room who obviously are going to be a bit down after that 1 point loss?
Yeah, it will be tough for the Broncos. And I mean, you know, they've come into the game with the same expectations as us, knowing that it's important before Origin comes around to win the game. So, but you know, I guess, you know, there's some performances there that were pretty positive. I guess that's what you've got to work on, and a couple of players are available, which is positive for Queensland. I'm sure they'll turn around and be up for the first game.
Well, congratulations and savour the victory.
Thank you, we will.
Michael Hagan, the Knights coach, now the pick the score dividend on tonight. Newcastle 17, Broncos 16, $714.35. Right, Friday Night Football, it has been a supreme night of rugby league. A win to Newcastle in Golden Point extra time, 17 points to 16. We're back on deck on Sunday. Our clash from Parramatta Stadium, the Eels against the Melbourne Storm. Until next time, enjoy your footy.
been watching Friday Night Football on Nine's Wide World of Sports.